If you're struggling to get your teams aligned onto one tool, you are going to love this video. I'm going to be breaking down for us how you can have different teams working in different environments, different software, but we're going to show how we can actually build one centralized source of data thanks to some cool syncing options across tools. So if learning more about how to get your team operating with one source of truth is of interest to you, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth and this is Gap Consulting. It's our mission to help you unlock the full potential of no-code tools, which we honestly see as the future of software in the working environment. Now, before we get into the heart of things, I first want to invite you to join me for some training. If you're new to no code, you are going to want to learn how to leverage automation. This will allow you to take those repetitive, mundane tasks that you do day in and day out and set them on autopilot so that they just perform in the background without your thinking about it. Go ahead and sign up for my free training at gapconsulting.io/webinar-registration. You don't have to know how to code. That's the whole point of this. And we're going to teach you the fundamentals of building automation that saves you time. But without further ado, let's hop on into the heart of this video, and we are really going to be weighing two different software options. Now, it's no secret on this channel that Notion is not my favorite software, but it is commonly used, and we can't just ignore that fact. Now, on the other hand, I love Airtable, and we've built this channel and our business around Airtable. But the fact of the matter exists that many people use both of these tools, or they strongly prefer, as in my case, one over the other. Now, we all know the problems of tool fatigue, and if you start in an environment and you try to convince a particular team that they need to use a specific tool, you can very often find yourself facing an uphill battle. A lot of times, especially in business, certain teams will gravitate towards certain tools. And to that end, Notion can be really helpful for a lot of things. Specifically, many folks use Notion as kind of the dashboard for everything. You can put a lot of information in Notion and make it really presentable and quite attractive. And a lot of different teams and professions are going to gravitate towards that. And on the Airtable side of things, you've got a software that allows you to store almost endless amounts of data. You can build any database you can imagine, and you don't have to know how to code. You don't need an application to use it. So you've got two different software that are similar in nature, but many people use them for different reasons. So what happens if you come into a team and all of a sudden you've got folks using Notion on one side, you've got folks using Airtable on the other? You know, is it in your best interest to try to convert an entire organization to one software? Or does it make more sense to say, hey, let's pull the data that we need out of these tools and have a single source of truth? One place that we have synced to everything so that when information changes in one environment or the other, we know it in our source of truth. Now, we're going to break it down exactly how to build these syncs in this video. But before we get there, I want to talk about some of the reasons that you might want to take this approach. Namely, a lot of folks are trying to put all of their data into a single source of truth for the purpose of AI. If you are starting to lean on AI more and more in your forward-thinking organization, then you're going to want to make sure that the data that you're using, that you're feeding to that AI machine, is in fact the right data. So making sure that you have updated information is critical. Now, another reason that folks might want to consolidate all of that information into one source of truth comes down to licensing issues. A lot of times when you're on these different software plans, the more seats that you have on the plan, the higher your monthly bill will be. But if you were to consolidate all of that data into one place and only share access with a limited number of people, then all of a sudden you've been able to successfully lower your bills as well. So you've built this single source of truth, communicates cleanly with AI, lowers your monthly bills, and now you're in a position to really take advantage of a true syncing opportunity. But of course, natively, these tools do not offer syncing to one another for obvious reasons. So how can you start to tap into that? Well, that is where we're going to pull in and use a third-party tool called Whalesync. Now, we've shown off Whalesync a few times before on this channel, and we're seeing more and more of a demand for tools like this, so you can expect more content along these lines. But what Whalesync allows us to do is build not an automation between one tool to another, but a true and proper sync, so that if information changes in one or the other of those data sources, it will be updated in the other place. And in this example, we're going to show off how we can combine Notion and Airtable in a true sync. Now, first of all, I'm here in Notion and I have a personal CRM template that I'm going to be using. So we've got the different contacts right here in our contacts table. And you can also see that we've got a particular view cut out of the professional contacts that is filtered down to only show Marcus, because if we were to scroll over, well, Marcus has been marked as a professional contact. But we might want to consider putting together this same information to an Airtable source. So let's flip on into Airtable. And here, I've already installed the template from Airtable called the Sales CRM. Now, in both cases, I'm using templates. So the first thing I need to do is to make sure that I've got a mapping capability for my data. So over here inside of Notion, you see I've got a name, I've got associations, I've got a last update, I've got a status, a last contacted. If we scroll over, we see we also have professional contact. And over here, we can see we've got a column that is no longer working, so I'm gonna go ahead and delete this property. Now, if we flip back into Airtable, we'll wanna make sure that we have at least the same components that we want to map into Airtable. In addition to this, we probably also want to have some sort of contact information. So how are we keeping track of these folks? Are we calling them on the phone? Do we have email access? How are we bringing in that information? So we might want to add that as well. Let me just bring in an email field type here. I'll go with email address and we will add that property. So now I have that. Let me drag it on over here and I'll just put in some examples. I'll say an add example. .com. All right, so you get the idea. I'm storing this information here, and I want it to automatically sync over to Airtable. But I also want changes in my Airtable database to sync back to the other. So over here in Airtable, again in my sales CRM template, I have something similar. So here I've got name. Let me move over my email address. And I've got account here. This is linking, because remember, Airtable's the database of all things. It's linking my contacts to my accounts, which I don't need for our particular sync here. So let's just suppose that we want to care about primarily two fields, the name and the email, because I have this similar field in both of my different properties. So over here, Airtable in my contacts table, name and email, and back inside of Notion, I've got name and email. Now, of course, I could map additional fields, but for our example, I want to keep it on the simpler side. So we first head into Whalesync and we establish our sync. Now, no data sources have yet been defined, so let's first select an app. So we can see all the different things that we can sync with from Whalesync, and I'm going to choose Notion here and authorize. Now, this is going to pop up on my screen and ask me to go through the steps of giving permission for Whalesync to talk to Notion. So I'm going to choose my workspace, select my pages if there's only a particular page I want to share, and we can move on to the next one. In particular, I care about my personal CRM here on this sync, so I'll allow that access. Now that we're talking to Notion, we have to choose where we want to sync this. So in what workspace? And here I am inside of a workspace called Gareth's workspace, and I will save that connection. Now that's only one part of the equation. The second part is going to be syncing with my Airtable database. So here I make my choice to set up an authorization to Airtable. And we can provide the base sharing link here. Now, if you're not really comfortable doing this, let's click here. It's gonna walk us through how to generate that base sharing link. And we basically look at Airtable, we say, we're gonna share this publicly. We turn on full base access and we can watch this GIF unfold. And this is the URL we are looking for. So this is all provided for us by Whalesync. Again, if you're newer to this, I'm gonna go ahead and flip back into Airtable. In the upper right corner, click on share, share publicly, enable the shared base link, and this is the link that we are looking for. So now that we're here, let's pop back into Whalesync and paste our base sharing link. And if you choose to make it password protected, you can do that. for a little bit of additional security, and then toggle this on. Now for our example, we don't need that. We will authorize this from here, and we are taken to the actual authorization screen, and we now need to add that database. Now ours is called Sales CRM, and we have it right here in the orange. We will grant this access. That is now talking to our Sales CRM template. And similarly to last time, we're gonna have to save this connection once we are all happy with the setup. So we've now got both of the different components talking. So we're seeing here that no data will be synced until we activate the sync, but we also need to actually map those fields, one field to the other, one column to the other. So we're gonna go and say continue here. And so we can see that we've got the Gareth's workspace in Notion syncing with our sales CRM. That is what we need. Now it's time for some table mappings. We're going to map that data from one to the other and vice versa. So over here, we have our contacts table, yes. And in our Airtable setup, remember in Airtable, we've got four different tables. So we wanna make sure that we're talking to the right table. And in tables, we've got contacts. And also note that we've got these views where we could see all the contacts or the VIP. If we flip into Airtable, go back to contacts, these are the views here. We want to make sure, for our example anyway, that we're syncing the whole data set. So I'm going with all contacts, which has no filters applied. So let's go ahead and make that selection here. And now it's time for the table mappings. Now we can click on select the suggested table mappings as well if we just want to kind of go through the expedited process, but I don't mind doing it manually. I've made the selections here. Let's create the table mapping. It's going to analyze our backend, and it says one fields were mapped automatically, and let's go ahead and skip that automatic mapping, and we're going to pick the values. Remember, I have only two fields that I care about to sync here. The first one is name inside of my Notion. Let's flip into Notion and verify that. We have this field called name, or as Notion says, property is the name of a column. So this property says name, this property is email address. Flipping back into Whalesync, I want name from Notion to map to the name in Airtable. Let's flip into Airtable to verify. This column is called field, this column, email. That's what we are mapping. Here I'm gonna make the selection for email address, mapping it to email. And I think we're good from here. So all we need to do is save and exit, and we are going to prepare the initial sync. So let's go ahead and set up the initial sync the first time it's gonna talk to itself. We're gonna scan records, and it's gonna show us now the different information that it finds. We see over here it found 6 records in Notion and 19 in Airtable. Does that match up? Yes, it does. Here in Notion, I've got my 6 example records. And here in Airtable, we can see on the counter down here that we have 19 different contacts. So that's what it's identifying. That's exactly what we need. We're going to continue. And it's saying, hey, we don't already have a match. There's not a record in one place that matches with the other. And that's what we would expect. Let's go ahead and continue again. And what it's going to do is create those extra records inside of Notion. Note that this is going one direction on this particular side of things. And when we continue, we will activate that sync. Things to note before turning the sync on, if you sync files from Airtable attachment fields, Whalesync does not guarantee that the original file name will be preserved. We're not dealing with files here, but if you are working with attachment fields, do note that the original file name will not necessarily be preserved. And here we go, we've got a sync. We can see that those records are being added right here. They are coming from the Airtable CRM, getting added into Notion. Now in the future, any changes that we make to the two fields in Airtable are going to then automatically resync through Whalesync so that our source of truth in Notion is kept up to date. Now we could do this the other direction as well. We could say we want to take any changes in Notion and push them to Airtable. We could make this a bi-directional sync so that a change in one or the other would impact the other data source as well. You can see that it's slowly going through the different contacts that it found in Airtable. But if we pop into Notion now, we're going to actually see all of these new pieces of data, all these new records getting added into Notion. And of course, we can tell which ones came from Airtable because they only have these two components. They only have the name and the email address, whereas the rest of the data is left blank because it's not coming over in our sync. So you can see how much this will really help you. It's different from an automation because an automation does its action one time. And that is not what's happening here. We're not saying, hey, only if I check a box do I want you to send this data to Notion. In Whalesync, any updates in Airtable will be reflected here in Notion. And as I said, we could turn that other directions as well so that we have our source of truth wherever we want it. This way we can say, hey, marketing team, if you want to keep working in Notion, go for it. Finance team, if you want to keep working in Airtable, go for it. We are going to build our source of truth from these different sets of data, from the different software that you're using, and we're going to bring it where we need it to work on for whatever our process is. I know we went quickly in this video and covered a lot, but if you have questions, feel free to swing by our website and ask. And of course, if you got value from this, give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel. But most importantly, keep on building.